But I know you have one thing that we're not allowed to ask. What is it? Can you explain it?
Yeah, I would appreciate a lot if you tonight ask me against who I play next round, because I don't know and I never check. I only check the schedule, so that's when I know when I'm playing and against who I'm playing. And I also don't want to know when they are playing my opponents. And it's not a superstition, it's just that since 2 years I'm doing this and it helps me much more being more focused.
Thank you. Yeah, you played an amazing match that was for the spectators. It was awesome to watch, but also was like a roller coaster for the two of you. You were up 5-2 in the second, and you had third match points in a row, but then you lost the set, then you were up again, 5-2. Like, can you talk us through the match and through your emotions?
Yeah, I had the first match point I should have won, because that's when I had a good chance to win. And then she was playing really good on all my match points. Maybe I was not so aggressive as well, but she always had really good tactic on the match points. And then I kind of hurried a little bit or got stressed, because it all depended on my match today, if I would get a special exam for the next tournament in Luxembourg. And if not, I was supposed to drive and in the night and play the next day, maybe two matches if I was winning the first one. So I was everything in my mind was really, really messed up. And but then she played well, I was rushing, and then third set I played again okay. And after that, on 5-3, I think I had match points, or 5, I don't remember exactly, but again, she played well, and maybe I was not attacking, just to risk a little bit more.
Would you consider this the biggest victory of your career?
Yes, I mean, she was top 10, so for me, I know she was injured, so maybe she's not playing at the same level as before, but she had some good results lately, with some really good wins. And for me, it was really important to pass this match and to get through it, also in a super in a tiebreak, third set. So,
what does that mean for you, like reaching the top 100 now, for the first time in your career, with as a 29-year-old, which,
yeah.
which I haven't been for 10 years now, the WTA Tour, and also your first. Yeah, semi-finals in your career, and what does that mean to you, especially since you like wanted to quit tennis? Tell us about it.
So I think right now I just start to believe that you can do it. Doesn't matter the age, as long as you're fit and you're feeling good on the court, you can be over 30 and you can still play and win. Before I wasn't thinking about this because of my injuries, and I never had this ranking or these high results. So I always thought it's not possible. When you're almost 30, it's time maybe to retire if you didn't make it, and then do something else. I don't know, have a family or coach or I don't know, work somewhere else. But now I really think and I really hope I can be an example for other players who maybe were in my position and would want to quit, or I don't know, just don't want to continue. I think it's, if you really want to and you really believe in it, you just have to go and play, and then results are coming. It doesn't matter the age.
What did you think when Belinda sent out the last for end of the match on the match point?
Oh, it was the first time when I was swimming after winning all the matches here. I was so released because I had all the match points and I couldn't do it, and I just thought, oh my god, I'm playing a semi-final, I never played, so I just hope more to come. Yeah.
Well, you know, if someone told you at the beginning of this week, actually last week because you came here for the qualies, they told you, yeah, you'll be sitting here talking about reaching the semi-final.
It's actually true. My coach this week with me, Justyna Jagielka, from Poland, she was telling me this, and I was like, in a joke, of course not, I wasn't even thinking I'm gonna pass the qualies, because I was coming from team matches in Romania, which were on clay court, and I couldn't even practice on hard court for, like, in the last few days before I came. So I was like, okay, she believes in me, let's see, match by match. So it's amazing, yeah, it's really amazing.
Correct me, but it doesn't seem like you play often indoor.
Well, yes, because most of the time, at the end of the year, I didn't play so many tournaments. In the last years, I was injured, so I had break for 2.5 years. So, no, not so many tournaments I have indoor. But it seems okay for me indoor as well. I mean, I had an ITF, I think, indoor, and I had a final 2 years ago, but still, yeah, not so many.
You look a very emotional player on court, while you play. Is it something that helps you to play better?
I think, but I would probably need to work on that further on. But it helps me. It helps me forget the bad shots or the bad points and then move on the next ones.
Here we can squeeze in a fan question from Facebook. Lou Miller is asking, do you think the rise of Simona Halep has given courage to many players in Romania?
Yes, actually it's true. Since she became so popular in our country, tennis has begun to be also more popular. Like, young kids go to tennis, we have some new clubs in Romania, and it's getting bigger and bigger. People know more, it's not just only football anymore, so that's really good, actually. So it's...
Why is it working out for female tennis in Romania and not for men?
Because I think we are more serious on the court than the men, to be honest. And I think it's also more difficult for the men because the level is higher in the men's circuit. It's more than 2,000 players in the ranking, and for us it's maybe only 1,200, I think. And
only,
yes, it's a lot still, but most of them, when they get to 18, 19, they all try to go college if they didn't make it or they quit. And we don't have so many coaches who really want to help us, and then it's tough also with the sponsorship so that they can travel, and then most of them quit, to be honest. They finish because they struggle a lot.
You are in the semifinals also in doubles. You entered in the top 100 also in doubles for the first time.
Yeah.
What do you like about doubles?
I always played both when I was, every time I'm playing, so I didn't. It's really nice because you can make some tactics when you play doubles, and you can work on your volley a lot, and you can be more aggressive in attack. Maybe I should have done it more today, but still. Yeah.
How important was for you the US Open?
Oh, it was really important because that's when I really thought that I can really get into top 100 and I can play at this level, and that my place can be also around these girls. And before, I always thought that I'm not that good enough. So then I thought about it, and I think it was really important for me to win those matches.
Yeah, that was the first time you actually qualified for a Grand Slam, and you played Caroline Wozniacki in the first round. Yeah, tell us what that meant to you.
It was really good that I played against her. All that, it was the toughest draw for a qualifier. It remembered me when we played against each other in the juniors. I never won against her, but it was always a tough match. So, as I said a few days ago also, I was just a little bit disappointed after the match. I didn't play longer, so the match was not like over 2 hours because I wanted to play more. But I just thought when I played against her that I can make it, like I can be there as well, really. I mean, I felt that it's not like they're totally different level. I mean, they're also human, they're players, so that we can also be somewhere close by.
And she has been nice to you.
Yes, she has been really nice, and she talked with me before the match, and in all Grand Slams that we met in the last years, she was always saying hi to me and how are you, and she was disappointed of my injuries, and she always told me, and her father as well, that I can still make it and I have to go forward and forward. And also Tsibulkova, we met this year in Australian Open, and she was really nice and she spoke with me. So I was happy because we were in the same level in juniors.
You talked about the many young guys quitting because of struggling financially, and I think you must have been in the same situation. Mm-hmm. What kept you going? Because of course the injuries are physical, but there's also not playing, there's no money. And
well, most of us play team matches in different countries, so that helps us. If you don't have a sponsor, it helps you play tournaments after. So I played a lot of team matches in the last few years, and that helped me continue playing tournaments after. So also I had okay ranking, so based on your ranking you can get much more amount of money for each match, so then for me it was okay for playing tournaments, but for the men it's really difficult. And then maybe I was lucky having contacts in more countries than the men, so that's why it's really tough in Romania to get a sponsor. I mean, I'm by myself since I was almost 20. I'm like independent, and yeah, it's tough for Romanian players to go travel all the time. So I was always mostly alone playing tournaments. So most Romanians are going and traveling alone. It's really tough.
You get like a nice prize money check now. Did you already look up
No.
I don't. what do you? That's also like super thing.
I don't know. I just don't check the job and I don't check anything anymore.
Will you buy yourself a present or something?
Maybe to my parents. Because they always helped me when I was younger. So my father, he's actually my coach. He's always been my coach. So I owe everything to him, because if he wasn't there, I wasn't playing tennis. And he was always there when I was screaming in matches, or I don't know what I was doing. And he was always there to support me. And him and my mother were the only ones, and also close by friends, saying that I can still make it when I wanted to quit. So maybe... Well, I didn't think about some present yet. I will probably play more tournaments with this amount of money, I guess.
Someone on Twitter asked about your tapes all over your body. Are you feeling okay?
Well, it's okay. I mean, I'm getting tired every day more and more, but it helps me feel more stabilized on the court with the tapes. And I had some inguinal problems, so that's why I had to be taped on my leg. And with the shoulder is something already for a couple of months, and I need to be taped so that I don't have pain during the match. And before and after I need some treatment. But it's nothing to be worried about. They said it's only because of tiredness, everything, because I played in the last 4 months really a lot of tournaments. So yeah, that's why I'm okay.
Can you tell us, since like a lot of people don't know you yet so much, something about your personality? What should we know about you? What are you?
Well, I'm an open person, friendly, and I like to socialize with people. And most of the time, when I have free time, I like to travel or visit. I like to ski, and then of course I like to go shopping. Which girl doesn't like to? And I'm not a person who goes so much into reading, because I don't have time, and whenever I have some free time, I just want to relax. I'm just, I think, regular person without superstitions or things like that.
Maybe last question?
Well, you said skiing. That's interesting.
Normally I'm not alone. Yeah, but I like a lot.
Is the Winter Olympics coming up?
So. Oh yeah, we should go try. No, I mean, I'm not that good, but I ski. I was this year as well skiing a little bit, and almost every year I try to go a few days and ski, because it relaxes me and it's a sport which I like a lot.
So if there was one sport in the Winter Olympics you would do, it would be alpine skiing?
Could might have been, yeah. But my dad was not a skier, so he was in tennis. I was introduced in tennis then.
Is there any favorite skier, you think?
Not that much, to be honest. I like to ski, but I'm not watching many competitions, and I'm not familiar with the players, the athletes. But it's just a hobby that I like to do for myself. It really relaxes me a lot.
Yeah, you can do that in Austria, actually.
Well, I've never been, and I really want to come.
Oh, we'll arrange something for you.
Innsbruck, right? Or it's
all over.
Okay,
we can change them. Thank you so much, and good luck for your next match. We won't tell you who it is.
Yes, thank you very much.